When I said don't try this at home, I meant it.
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to a rather somber episode of The World According to Jon. My name is, as you know, Jon Paula. And today I have a rather troubling and terribly tragic story to share with you today that is rather close to home. It's a local news story that's been coming out of Fulton, Illinois this week. On November 23rd, a 150-year-old historic pharmacy apartment building burned down to the ground, and a, I'm sure, lovely 41-year-old mother of two burned in this fire. And that's the kind of thing that happens in every small town or city, probably like every day across this country. The reason I'm bringing this particular story to you today is because of its eerily sad connection with what I do for a living. If you don't know, I have another channel here on YouTube, jpizzle1122, and my flagship production on that channel is a show called Is It a Good Idea to Microwave This? Myself, my friends Jory Karen and Riley McElwain helped me, and over the last 300 episodes, we've microwaved hundreds of objects, and it's all been quite a lot of fun, but we do so with good safety precautions in mind. We do so behind a barricaded shield with the best in video equipment, the best in safety gear, fire extinguishers, do it all outside, and we make sure to let you guys know at home you shouldn't attempt it on your own time. That being said, over the past few years, as our show has gained popularity, many of you have decided to do your own little parodies and your own copycat shows. For the most part, there's nothing I can do about that. I would like to encourage you again to not copy what we do at home. It is quite dangerous, and we are very good at what we do, and we've taken many safety precautions, and we've still had close calls. So you shouldn't try it at home, especially in your own kitchen. Unfortunately, that message has not gotten through to all of you. One particular individual this seemingly did not get through to was Logan Sipe. He's a 12-year-old. His mother was the one that died in the fire last week. That fire is a strong possibility it was caused by Logan microwaving something in his apartment building. I have no proof that Logan has in any way directly been influenced by my program here on YouTube. I don't know that he saw mine and copied it, or if he just got the same random idea we did, or if he got it from another similar YouTube channel that also microwaves stuff. I mean, God knows we're not the only ones on here that do this. We're just the best and most popular. So I don't know if Logan got his particular idea for a channel from us. Yes, his show is called Microwave This, which is very similar to our title, but he's not subscribed to us, and in none of his videos does he make any references or jokes to Jory, myself, or Riley. So I'm not sure that Logan actually knows who we are, but I certainly know who he is. When I first heard this story, it was brought to my attention by one of my YouTube viewers, and, well, you know, my heart immediately sank, because it's like, oh geez, this, pets were lost, memories, items, and this child's mother. It took them 3 days to find Charlene's body in the rubble. This is a terrible tragedy, and it does nothing but further echo my point that when we say don't try this at home, we really mean it. Which is unfortunate for Logan, because I guess he didn't get that message. And apparently he had the consent and approval of his mother. So while I'm not sure he was doing this under adult supervision, he at least had the adult's permission. I don't think that makes this any easier to swallow, certainly, because his mother is now gone. But what enrages me more than anything else with this story are the people going to Logan's Facebook and YouTube pages and berating this poor child who just lost a parent. I trust he's not going to keep posting these YouTube videos. I also trust he's quite incredibly sorry for what he did. He did not intend to burn down a building. Of course not. He's trying to have some fun. Yes, he shouldn't have in the first place. He lost his mom. Cut him some slack. Either way, on the 30th of November, a week after the fire, 12-year-old Logan Sipe was charged and will be brought to juvenile court in connection with this fire. As I said, the cause of the fire is still under investigation, but the police aren't idiots. They saw the same YouTube channel you and I did, and they can put two and two together, and it seems quite likely that Logan may be responsible for a fire that took the life of his own 41-year-old mother. Well, that's all I have to say about that. My name is Jon, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.